So in our previous lecture, we learnt about the problems related to the chapter dielectrics. So here in this class also we'll continue the same thing. So here we have the fifth question. A sphere of diameter 0.05 meter is charged to a potential of 1000 volts. So you have a sphere which has got a diameter of 0.05 meter, and this sphere has been charged to the potential of 1000 volts. Now calculate the outward pull per unit area given diameter of the sphere as 0.05 meter. So here what we have to find? We have to find outward pull per unit area. So we have the diameter as 0.05 meter. So we need to convert this to radius. So radius will be equals to 0.05 divided by 2. So we know the relationship between electric field and the potential. So E can be written as V by R, because the formula for E is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square, and the formula for V is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R. So if you divide R to the potential, you will get electric field. So if I write here, so electric field is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. Potential is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R. So if you divide this potential with R, then you get electric field. So E will be equals to V by R. So similar to these two equations, you have force equation also. It is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R square. So this is Coulomb's law. So in Coulomb's law, we get to know that force between two charges which are separated by distance r in the air, then we can write force as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R square. So from this force we derive the electric field, and from electric field we'll write the potential. So here we need the potential formula, that is E is equals to V by R. So let us write E is equals to what? V by R. So potential is how much? So he has mentioned in the question potential is 1000 volts. 1000 volts divided by R. How much did we get? 0.05 divided by 2. That is 0.025 meters. So substitute this here. So 0.025 meters. So 1000 volts divided by 0.025. So that means you get nearly 40,000. Or you can also write this as 4 into 10 power 4 Newton per Coulomb. So the unit for electric field is Newton per Coulomb. So how do we get this Newton per Coulomb? So if you observe here, the force has got an equation 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R square. So the unit for force is Newton. So if you divide this force with Q, F by Q, then you get electric field. So the unit for this field will be what now? So the force, unit of force is Newton, unit of charge is Coulomb. So electric field will be Newton per Coulomb unit. So that is what I have written here. So 4 into 10 power 4 Newton per Coulomb. So now we have found what is electric field. So why did we find electric field? Because, so in our outward pull per unit formula, we have electric field. So the equation or the expression for outward pull per unit area is P is equals to epsilon naught E square by 2. So P is equals to epsilon naught E square by 2. So we know the value of epsilon naught, and we found the value of electric field. So let us substitute both these values in the expression to find outward pull per unit area. So epsilon naught has got a value of 8.85 × 10⁻¹². And the electric field has got the value of 4 × 10⁴ Newton per coulomb whole square. So divided by 2. So you can also write this expression as 8.85 × 10⁻¹² into 4 × 10⁴ into 4 × 10⁴ divided by 2. So 2 ones, 2 twos, 4 twos, 8. So 8.85 × 10⁻¹. So let me not write that. So 4 twos, 8. So we have 8 here. And 4 plus 4, 8. So 12 minus 8 is minus 4. So 8.85 × 8 × 10⁻¹² will give you 70.8 × 10⁻⁴ Newton per meters square. So this is what the outward pull per unit area. So outward pull per unit area. Clear? So we got it as P is equal to 70.8 × 10⁻⁴ Newton per meter square. So this is all the solution for the question number, how much? It is 5. So question number 5 says a sphere of diameter 0.05 meter is charged to a potential of 1000 volts. So for this we need to calculate the outward pull per unit area. So to do this, first we need to know the expression for P. So this is the expression for P. P is what? P is equals to epsilon naught multiplied by E square by 2. And to find this E, we have used this expression because this value is given to us. So if he gives us the value of charge, then we should use this expression to find the electric field. So then what we have done, so we have just directly substituted the values of epsilon naught and E square. Then finally we got P is equals to 70.8 × 10⁻⁴ Newton per meter square. So this is the solution for the fifth question. So now next let us move to the sixth question. So here we have the sixth question. An insulated soap bubble of 6 cm radius is given a charge of 48 × 10⁻⁹ coulomb, that means 48 nano coulomb. So you have an insulated soap bubble which has got the radius of 6 cm. So for this soap bubble you have given a charge of 48 nano coulomb. So the atmospheric pressure is 10⁵ Newton per meter square. Then calculate the increase in the radius due to charge, neglecting the surface tension effect. So what he has asked? So he has asked us to calculate the increase in radius due to the charge. So you are giving a charge to the soap bubble which is 48 × 10⁻⁹ coulomb, and he has also mentioned the atmospheric pressure. So it is 10⁵ Newton per meter square. So for this we need to find what will be the increase in radius. So to do that, first let us write the given data. So here we have radius of the soap bubble as, so radius of soap bubble, so which is given to us, so you can denote it as R. So it is 6 cm. So this will be equals to 6 × 10⁻²  meters. So you should be thorough with the factors. So centi has got 10⁻², nano is 10⁻⁹. So if you are good in the factors, then you can directly write them in meters. Next is charge on soap bubble. Charge on the soap bubble. So this can be written as Q. So Q is what? 48 into 10 power minus 9 coulomb, that is 48 nano coulomb. Next, he has mentioned atmospheric pressure value. Atmospheric pressure. So it is somewhere around 10 power 5 Newton per meter square. So now these are the three data which we have. So with this data, we have to find what is the increase in the radius due to the charge. So here we are totally neglecting about the surface tension effect. So we are not worried about this surface tension effect. So we are concentrated only on the increase in radius due to charge. So how much charge? 48 nano coulomb. So let us continue. The increase in radius of the soap bubble. So here we have to find the increase in radius of soap bubble. So for that we have dr. So dr is what? So change in the radius of the soap bubble. So dr is equals to how much we got? Q square divided by 96 into epsilon naught pi square pr cube. So this is what we got. So for this, so if you substitute the values, so Q square is what? 48 into 10 power minus 9 whole square divided by 96 into 8.85 into 10 power minus 12 into pi square is 3.143 or 2. So pi square into pressure is how much? 10 power 5. So multiplied by r cube. R cube is 6 into 10 power minus 2 whole cube. So you have 48 divided by all these things. So if you write this as 48 into 10 power minus 9 into 48 into 10 power minus 9 whole divided by 96 into 8.85 into 10 power minus 12 into 3.142 whole square into 10 power 5 into 6 into 10 power minus 2 whole cube. Now 48 twos is 96. So 48 twos is 96. What left is? So let me write that here. So what is left? So we have 48 into 10 power minus 9 into 10 power minus 9. So what we have here is 10 power minus 9 minus 9 minus 18. 48 into 10 power minus 18 whole divided by 2 into 8.85 into 10 power minus 12 into 3.142 whole square into 10 power 5 into 6 into 10 power minus 2 whole cube. So now if you solve this whole equation, then you get final answer as 1.27 into 10 power minus 8 centimeter, that is change in radius. So what we have done here, so we have directly taken this equation and then we have solved for the change in the radius of the sphere or soap bubble due to the charge. So to do this, first you have to write the given data in a required format. So if they are not in SI units, then convert them to SI unit. Then finally you know the expression for dr. dr is what? Dr is equals to q square divided by 96 into epsilon naught pi square pr cube. So this expression we have derived in our previous lectures. So for this, if you substitute all the values which you have got in the question, then you get final answer as dr is equals to 1.27 into 10 power minus 18 centimeter. So with this, let us move to the next question. So here we have seventh question. So a soap bubble has a radius of 1 centimeter. So when charged to a potential of 10,000 volts, so soap bubble has got a radius of how much? 1 centimeter. So after charging from to a potential of 10,000 volts, so the excess of pressure inside the bubble, this is the surface of soap solution, being 3 into 10 minus 2 newton per meter. So here it is surface tension. So what has given to us? So a soap bubble has a radius of 1 centimeter when charged to a potential of 10,000 volts. So here we have to calculate the excess of pressure inside the bubble. The surface tension of soap solution being is 3 into 10 power minus 2 newton per meter. So I missed writing tension here. Please add that in the question. So let us first write the given data. So given data is, so first what he has given, he has given the radius of soap bubble. So radius of soap bubble is how much? R is equals to 1 centimeter. So you can write this as 1 into 10 power minus 2 meters. So this is the radius of soap bubble. Next, what we have the potential of soap bubble. So potential of soap bubble is how much? So it is 10 power 4 or 10,000 volts. So 10,000 volts can also be written as 10 power 4 volts. Clear. Next, we have surface tension. So here we have surface tension. So surface tension, the value of this is, so we should denote this. So T is equals to 3 into 10 power minus 2 newton per meter. So with all this data, what we have to find? We have to find the excess of pressure inside the bubble. So while explaining about this soap bubble, I said that so pressure inside the soap bubble will be greater than atmospheric pressure or pressure outside the soap bubble. So if you increase the surface pressure inside the soap bubble, then there is a point at which this bubble can burst and the pressure will change. So with that concept, here we have to find pressure inside the soap bubble. So first let us find the pressure inside the soap bubble. So it can be written as P is equals to 4 pi by R. So we know what is pi. So pi is 3.143. So this is not pi, this is T. So 4 T by is the pressure, 4 into T by R. So T is how much? 3 into 10 power minus 2 divided by R is how much? So it is 1 into 10 power minus 2. So 10 power minus 2, 10 power minus 2 will get cancelled. What remains is P is equals to 4, 3 is 12, 12 newton per meter square. So we found what is the pressure inside the soap bubble. So it is P is equals to 12 newton per meter square. Next, what we have to find is potential of a bubble. So we know that V is equals to what? 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R. So now we don't know what is Q. So let us write this equation in terms of q. So q will be what v into 4 pi epsilon naught into r. So this will be the expression for q. Now here we know what is v, what is r. So v is how much? Potential of a soap bubble is 10 power 4 and radius of soap bubble is 1 into 10 power minus 2. So let us substitute that here. So we know the value of 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught as 9 into 10 power 9. So here we have 4 pi epsilon naught. So we can write q is equals to 10 power 4 into 1 divided by 9 into 10 power 9 into r is how much? So it is 10 power minus 2. So plus 4 minus 2 will be how much? 10 power 2. So 10 power 2 minus 9 divided by 9. So minus 9 plus 2 is minus 7. 10 power minus 7 divided by 9. So you get the value of q as 0.11 into 10 power minus 7 coulomb. So the fraction for 1 by 9 is 0.11 into 10 power minus 7 coulomb. So charge is measured in coulombs. So we got charge as 0.11 into 10 power minus 7 coulomb. So you can also write this in nano coulomb also. So 1 or 11 into 10 power minus 9 coulomb. So that implies 11 nano coulomb. So for 10 power 4 volts, we are getting charge as 11 nano coulomb. So next, with this charge, let us find what is the change in the radius. So we have to find what is the change in the radius. So here, let us find what is the change in the radius. Change in the radius. So that can be written as, so we know the expression for change in radius dr is equals to q square divided by 96 into epsilon naught pi square pr cube. So this is the expression for change in the radius. So you have to memorize this, all this expression, because if you try to solve the problems, then it will be difficult for you if you don't know the expression. So if you know the expression, then you can directly write the formulas and substitute the values and find the answer. So here we have dr is equals to q square divided by 96 into epsilon naught pi square pr cube. So that is equals to, so we got q as how much? 0.11 into 10 power minus 7 whole square divided by 96 into 8.85 into 10 power minus 12 into 3.142 whole square. And the pressure, how much we got? We got it as 12 newton per meter square. So P is 12 into radius is 10 power minus 2 whole cube. So this is the dr. So now let us solve, or if you solve, then you get dr as 1.2 into 10 power minus 3 meters. So this is dr. Next, what we have to find? We have to find change in pressure. Change in pressure. So that can be written as dp is equals to 3p by r into dr. So dp by dr is equals to 3p by r. So dp is equals to 3p by r into dr. So here you know what is 3p, it is 12, r is 10 power minus 2 into dr, we got it as, so 1.2 into 10 power minus 3 meters. So this is dp. So let if you calculate this, then you will get dP as 4.32 Newton per meter square. So dP is 4.32 Newton per meter square. So this is the overall solution for the question number 7. So this solution is quite large compared to 6, 5, 4, 3 problems. So 7th question has got a long solution. So if you understand the way I have solved this question, then it will be easy for you to do. Next, so this is the overall solution. So first, what we have done, so we have found what is the pressure inside the soap bubble. So why did we find the pressure inside the soap bubble? Because so to find the change in radius, we need pressure. So because of that, we found the pressure inside the soap bubble first. So P is equals to 4T by R. So substitute the values in P, then you get pressure as 12 Newton per meter square. Next, for this, we have to find potential of a bubble also. So potential can be written as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R. So we don't know Q here, so we know what is potential. So potential, the data for potential has been given in the question. So if we write Q is equals to 4 pi epsilon naught into R into V, then we get charge on the bubble as 11 nano coulomb. So that is what we have done now. So 11 nano coulomb. So this is the charge on the bubble. Next, what we did is, so we found change in radius. So change in radius is dr is equals to q square by 96 into epsilon naught pi square p r cube. So substitute the values in dr, then you get dr is equals to 1.2 into 10 power minus 3 meters. So with this dr value, we can find change in pressure. So change in pressure dp is equals to 3p by r into dr. Dp is equals to 3 into 12 divided by 10 power minus 2 into 1.2 into 10 power minus 3 meters. So dp is equals to 4.32 Newton per meter square. So this is overall solution for the question 7. So this solution is pretty large, so don't get scared. So try to solve it step by step, so then you will understand what could be the logic to solve this question. So with this, let us move to the next question. So you have one more question to solve. So 8th question. So 8th question is, if insulated soap bubble of 5.5 centimeter radius is given a charge of 6 nanocoulomb, if the atmospheric pressure is 10 power 5 Newton per meter square, then calculate the increase in radius due to the charge. So this question is also similar to the question that we have solved earlier. So here also we have to find what? So we have to find what is the increase in the radius due to charge. So he has given us the soap bubble which is insulated. So the radius of the soap bubble is 5.5 centimeter and the charge is 6 nanocoulomb, and he has given the atmospheric pressure as 10 power 5 Newton per meter square. So let us write the given data first. So we have, radius of soap bubble R is equals to 5.5 centimeters. So you can also write this 5.5 centimeter as 5.5 into 10 power minus 2 meters. Next, charge on the soap bubble. So charge on soap bubble Q can be written as what? 6 into 10 power minus 9 coulomb. So charge on the soap bubble is 6 into 10 power minus 9 coulomb. Next we have atmospheric pressure. So that is P is equals to 10 power 5 Newton per meter square. So next let us write the increase in the radius of the soap bubble. So for this you know the expression. What is the expression for increase in the radius of soap bubble? So it is the R is equals to Q square by 96 epsilon naught pi square P R cube. Q square divided by 96 into epsilon naught pi square P R cube. So you have the expression, you have the data, so just directly substitute and then find what is dr. So dr is equals to q is how much? 6 into 10 power minus 9 whole square divided by 96 into 8.85 into 10 power minus 12 into 3.142 whole square into 10 power 5 into 5.5 into 10 power minus 2 whole cube. So you have the expression and the data. So if you solve this, dr will be equals to 36 into 10 power minus 18 whole divided by 96 into 8.85 into 10 power minus 12 into 9.872 into 166.4 into 10 power 5 into 10 power minus 6. So for this, if you write dr, dr will be 36 into 10 power minus 18. Next, the denominator will have the value of 1.3956 into 10 power 6 into 10 power minus 3, minus 13. Next, if you solve this values, then you get it as 25.79 into 10 power minus 18 into 10 power 7. So if you solve this again, then you get 25 into 79 into how much? 10 power minus 11. So this can also be written as 2.579 into 10 power minus 10 centimeters. So this is what the change in the radius of the charged bubble. So what we have done, so we have taken the R expression and then we have substituted that, we have substituted the data in that expression. So if you look here, so this is the question. So if insulated soap bubble of 5.5 centimeter radius is given a charge of 6 nanocoulomb, if the atmospheric pressure is 10 power 5 newton per meter square, calculate the increase in the radius due to the charge. So to do that, first let us write the given data. So we have written here, so with the data then we can directly substitute that in the expression of dr. So dr is equals to q square by 96 into epsilon naught into pi square pr cube. So substitute the data which you have in the expression, then if you solve this, then you would get dr as 2.579 into 10 power minus 10 centimeters. So